Hey guys, Inder this side from 24x7 Everything. Hope you all are doing great. We are again back with another video, and this time it's on Zenfone Max Pro M1 related to the review of Bored Zen UI 5.6. So let's start with that. So for that, first we'll start with the camera to probe API. It's really good that out of the box this particular custom ROM is providing us the camera to probe API so that we can install the Google Cam and so on. So if you have already viewed my installation video, I have already shown you the installation of camera, like Google Cam as well. So if you haven't viewed that, we will be providing you the card link for the same, and as well as mention the video URL in the description below too. Now let's start with the DRM info. So basically this particular ROM again out of the box provide us L1 wide one certification so that you can stream your HD content on the go. So it's really also good. Let me close this as well, and now let's move to the performance part, and afterward we'll see the memory management and so on. So firstly, I'm going to refer the benchmark scores on the base of on the basis of Antutu. So again, you can see one warning that this device may be rooted. System parameters may have been changed due to the root, which may lead to inaccurate scores and so on. Yes, usually whenever we root our phone, then we do have some sort of like upper edge as compared to the stock ROMs which are being shipped by the manufacturer. So all in all, it is having overall score of 141,000. Then in CPU, it is showing nearly about 62,000. In GPU, nearly about 24,000, 24.5 thousand. Then in memory management, 32,000. And in UX or UI, it is 23,000. So as compared to the previous version, that is version 0.59 for the stock Android version or a stock Android update for the Asus Max Pro 1, these scores are somewhat or slightly better, or I would say higher. So now we have just moved to the Geekbench 4. Again, these are the single core scores, that is 1349, and these are the multi core scores, 4887. So it's like it are some like these scores as compared to version 0.59 are somewhat same, or hardly a minus or plus of 1 or 2 values. Now let me show you compute value. So render script is showing 4182. If I'm not wrong, even in 0.59 it was slightly same, or I would say just 5 to 10 like lower and above, or I would say below and above. And last part is related to Geekbench 5. So again, on a Geekbench 5, we have a multi-core score and single score. Single core is showing 281, multi-core is showing 1248. So even you can run these scores at your end, and you can see. One more thing I want to add, this is basically 6 plus 64 variant. So the scores might vary for the 3 plus 32 and 4 plus 64 as well. Now let's move to the compute part. Again, in Geekbench 4, we have two different set of algorithms. One is using Vulkan API and another is using OpenCL. with the Vulkan API, it is 253. With OpenCL, it is having 426. So even it is also good. Let me close these unwanted apps which we had already discussed. Okay, now let's move to the memory management. So I've already ran two games on my end and both are running fine. Although for PUBG, I'm just running on a balanced, or I would say a default setting. I have never played above. So you can try at your end. So firstly, I'm going to open PUBG. So you can imagine that it is by default loaded with the same home screen which I was accessing already earlier. So now let me open Call of Duty as well, and again we'll come back to see how the RAM management is this with this particular ROM. Now I'm going to open Call of Duty. So this is somewhere, no, yes, I think this might have reconnected with this server, but we'll again verify. Once it will open, I'll again open it and I'll show you the memory management again. So at present we are on a home screen of this. Let me go back and we'll again run PUBG first and afterward Call of Duty to see how the RAM management. Voila, so finally PUBG has been loaded on from the home screen itself. Now let's move to the Call of Duty. Voila, so even it has also opened on the home screen itself. So basically you can consider that its RAM management is really very fine, or it's working absolutely fine. Now let's discuss few other points. So there are bunch of settings available here. You can view any of, like, starting with these are just the Wi-Fi and mobile connection and so on, nothing major. Then FM radio is working absolutely fine. Then apart from this, this is night light, grayscale. There is one bummer that dark theme mode is not available here. So for that part, you have to move to settings and inside that display, and then on a system color scheme. So by default it is light, you can select dark and it will change to a dark mode. Now I'm again going to light and light. And even apart from this, there are bunch of settings on the like wallpaper, widgets, edit home screen, preferences and so on. Apart from this, let me show you one more thing from the app drawer's perspective. So there are so like view mode, manage apps, smart groups and so on. So by default it is view mode with the all apps, and if I'll change view mode to customize, then by default in the background our algorithm will run and it will group those apps, so you can view these apps that have been grouped. Now again I'll go to view mode, I'll select all and it will be like this. One more thing, you can also manage apps explicitly. So like this, I can move it here. I can move it here. I can also drag on another app to create a new group and so on. And in the same sense, smart group, it will also do the same thing, that is manage app or customize part is doing. And apart from this, there is another things that another major thing that I like was related to Borat's Roam settings. So you can play with these settings. So for this you need root access. So firstly I'll discuss these part. These are the advanced part. If you are familiar with the SE Linux mode, Wi-Fi channel with some Google Play patch, then you can Google Pay patch, then you can play with this. Otherwise you can skip this part. But these are the easiest part where you can change these part, number of icons or number of columns to be shown here. Like if it is showing 6, how much can it be shown? Number of quick settings rows. So by default I have 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. I can change this as well. The number of toggles in the, by default it is showing 6. You can also, like whenever you'll drag it for the first time, you can restrict it to 1, 2, 3 and so on. Then status bar, clock position. So I have already put it to left. That's why it's, if I'll put it on a right, then it will go back here. Then navigation bar, whether Zen UI, Zen UI or Borat's Roam and so on. And apart from this, let me see if there is anything else. Okay. Apart from this, you can use digital well-being, but at my end, I have when I was using this digital well-being, I have seen some sort of battery drainage of nearly about 5 to 6% on ideal on a daily basis. So I've turned on and now I'm hardly getting 1 or 2% of ideal drainage, not more than that. So it's your liking. So this was all from our side related to the review of these Borat's Zen UI 5.6, where we have seen camera to prob API and further on DRM info for the L1 wide certification, then memory management and then some of the benchmarks. And hope you like this video. If you really like this video, kindly share this with your friends and family. And apart from this, please subscribe to our channel, because this will surely motivate us and boost us to create more videos like this in the coming future. Finally, it's the time to sign off now. Bye for now. Thanks.